It's a podcast. It's a football podcast. We're live here at the G4 Claim Studios in Wishaw. Chelsea, Bobby Bob, Chris Toll, and the champ. What are you saying today?
Welcome. Joker 2 is shite.
Oh, heard about it, mate.
You seen it?
No, just heard it's shite.
You saw the lip syncing thing?
Never.
That's pretty interesting, Greg. Sorry to keep you going. Pull it up, Greg. See if somebody's already. It was at the premiere, and would you call him again?
Whacking Phoenix.
I did see this.
He's stunning with Lady Gaga.
It's a disaster or something.
He's like, this is a terrible movie. She's like, no, you're talking shit, you hanks her. He's like, no,
that's
it's
horrible.
It's terrible.
Who said this?
Yeah, Joking Phoenix.
Somebody's picked up with a lip syncing.
Whacking Phoenix.
No lip sync, that's no lip reading.
What did I say?
Joking Phoenix.
Joking Phoenix.
Whacking
Phoenix.
Oh.
No, it's not. Don't say that.
I do think it was.
You think so?
Certainly.
Oh, why is that?
Yes.
Why? What are you talking about?
The ending
about?
Could have been different.
No, I loved
you
it.
Did. Yikes.
I don't know if I believe yikes.
Nah.
I don't know if I believe yikes.
He's getting a wee bit Schofieldy in his old age.
What an actor, man.
I know.
He's phenomenal.
How intimidating do you think he would be on set? Put you off on it.
He's so good, man. He's aye, such a good actor. Brilliant.
What's your favourite Phoenix movie? Yeah, I'm fair to say his name again.
Just call him Joke.
Joke.
I think it's going to be Joker.
Joker?
I think he's Gladiator. Joker. Do you know what he was good in Signs. As well? Huh?
Signs.
Mm-hmm. He was good in, have you ever seen I'm Still Here?
No.
It's a good movie, I know.
He done one a few years ago.
We Own the Night. He's quite good in that.
Sure, grim as fuck. I can't remember the name yet.
So the one where he tries to get revenge on people and all that?
It's along the same lines as We Need to Talk About Kevin. Whatever that was called. We Have to Talk About Kevin. You seen that?
We Need to Talk About Kevin's absolutely grim. Oh, mate, here. Ah, buddy. Watched a trailer of that film. You said you watched it all night. Threads.
Mate,
holy bejesus.
Threads. I'm on a nostalgia page on Facebook. Right?
It was on BBC One, BBC Four the other night.
I know. And it's basically people put up like pictures and say, oh, remember this sweetie from back in the day, remember this TV show?
Aye.
And somebody put up this picture and it pure caught my eye. I was like, I wonder what that is. And he says, if you know, you know. And I had to fucking do a reverse search for the photo and all that because I didn't know. It turns out it was a show called Threads, right? It was a movie, and it's based in Sheffield, right?
The main guy for ID's in it.
ID. Have you ever seen ID?
No.
Right. So he's in it, Stevie. He's not in it for very long, to be honest.
Is he no?
No, it's about what would happen if there was a nuclear war.
It's pure excellent reviews.
It's set in Sheffield, mate, and it is one of the grimmest movies. It's
something to do with the Soviet Union. And
it's so realistic. It was during the Cold War, and it was what if America and Russia decided.
I wouldn't last with that. Man, I couldn't last.
Honest to God, it's so grim. But
Walk the line.
I was going to say, play Johnny Cash.
That's probably my favourite. I think I've watched Walk the Line about five or six times. I love it. I love Johnny Cash. I think his performance in that is phenomenal. And Reese Witherspoon's different gravy in that.
She's tremendous. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He plays his wife, doesn't
he? Yeah, June Carter.
I was going to tell my story about how I made an ass myself the other day, but I want to know what you've done. Just playing them out. You said you made an ass yourself this morning.
Right, so, till we hear this, right? So, I'm in work this morning, right? I've been in River City since day one, right? Mm-hmm. I walk about there.
An OG.
I like, I'm pretty, it's like home from home.
You don't, you're very humble.
No, I'm very humble, but it's like home from home. I feel very comfortable. I feel very, I love the place.
You wear your slippers and on that about the place. Like Lauren Kelly does.
Nah. So you're in there with every single person that passes. Hi, Stephen. Hiya, Margaret. Hi, Stephen. Hiya, Joanne. Knows everybody's name.
Nah, like, aye,
just
aye,
that, he's just the heart and soul of that aye, fucking
it,
place.
I love it.
For the bit polisher to like...
Aye, Scott winds me up, man, because he always says, you know, everybody's name. And I'm like...
Just, aye, because I hate that. Because then he cuddles everybody. I know. If you're with him, then you need to cuddle them. I know. I hate that. So, like, well, how you doing, doll?
Aye.
And so if I'm standing there, then it feels like you need to cuddle them too. I'm like, stop cuddling, folk.
I'm a very tactile
it's
human being.
It's annoying, mate. Aye, so anyway, awkward.
There's this guy who's been an SA for a while, on and after in there, right? And he's very over familiar. You'd maybe know him, right?
Right.
I can't remember his name, right? But unique fellow, right? So. This, now the SAs all line up in the morning, like outside the corridor. They all get checked by costume and all that, and go through all our stuff, right? So,
is that supporting artists?
Supporting artists. Yeah,
they don't like
it's no extras.
No extras.
Supporting artists.
Just for those.
Aye,
that
aye, exactly. Gervais, fuck
aye. So I went out right, and the water cooler's out there, right? So this guy is one of the guys, right? You see him. You see his eyes on you a mile away,
yes,
right?
You feel him,
and you know he's got to want to talk to you,
right?
No, that I don't want to talk to him, but I'm kind of in a rush. I'm about to go and set and I'm getting checked and all that, right? And I see him at the end of the queue and his eyes are staring right at me, right? And
aye,
like,
you can feel him. Aye. Aye.
So I'm going to the water queue and I'm like, fill my water up. And I just hear, no, there's about 40 extras there, right? Because it's outside, it's Christmas night, and they're all standing there getting ready and all that. And I'm filling my water up and I'm like, Stephen, you shrinking? And I'm like, in front of everybody, right? And I'm like, I didn't know what to say. Right?
I don't think I know as quickly as you're acting.
It's a belter. But the thing is, right, I'm still, everybody's there, and I can see the third AD wee Mark, right?
You take that?
Well, no, Mark's kind of mortified as well. And I can feel
embarrassed for you.
I can feel my face going pure red,
oh,
man.
No, man.
And I'm like, and Mark's done there, and Mark's like, what a terrible thing to say to somebody.
Oh, did you see that?
I said that to him. And the guys looked at me, but I turned around, and I just stared right at him, but it was like, I didn't know what to say, but I just kept staring at him.
You were stunned?
Aye, but I just kept, aye. I didn't take my eyes off him. And I thought my water up and I just walked away, man.
Did
I was like,
you?
I was like, because I thought if I bite and see it, I don't want to start a thing. But it's just like, Steve, in front of this corridor, told hundreds of folk in this corridor, right? And I'm filling my water up in the middle of them all. Stephen, you shrinking?
You just know the moral of the black. To all the supporting artists, everybody, just a note, nobody make a fool of you shouting. Don't make a fool of his height. Just really, he's having a better time out there now. There's too many folk coming in here and having a dig at his height. It's not on. Neighbour,
sure. Imagine I turned at a diva, man. You're not going on that set.
Nobody look at
me. Shout to me, Don, get him off this set.
You could be like that.
I would never do that.
Is, you should do that as a joke.
Aye, set it up.
Aye,
and we should film it.
Did the guy say it?
No, I just kept staring at him, mate. And I thought, I'm just going to keep staring at you while I'm filming my water up. And then I had to take my eyes off him because I was scared my water boat was going over.
Make a second to yourself.
But I was like, the boss on you, man. That's like fair dues, man.
Folk get too friendly, and that's like,
aye,
hang your mate. But mate, fair play, man. If that's like somebody going, all right, fatty.
Aye, I know. I was in it.
Aye, do you know what? Aye, that's workplace bullying.
Mm-hmm. All right, chubby. We were talking to Ryan about if you spoke to her, Chubby Brown, on the phone. All right, chubby. How are you doing, chub? Because we're meeting somebody that's.
We're meeting somebody about something, and we're saying, I wonder what other things he's involved with.
Roy Chubby
Brown at Blackpool Tower. He's like, do you want me to phone him now? Oh, Chubby.
Hey, you doing, Chubby?
Chubby, I've got a fucking grain on you, Chubby.
What's happening, Chubbs?
I've got a Chubby just told you, Chubby.
Oh man. But that was how my morning started. I was like, oh, wow, man. Fair to
well, so I finally met, try to be funny here, I finally met my brother-in-law. Who do you think that is?
Paddy?
No, James McAvoy.
Aye.
Right. Oh, James McAvoy.
You met James McAvoy?
No, I've not met him. I thought you would have, but Cosy Joy.
You never met him before? No, me neither.
Cosy Joy. I thought Cosy Joy. I thought you were a joy.
And so we were at a production office and he's working on something. anyway, and there's like a, what do you call it, communal kitchen.
Aye.
And
this is what I've seen for Curb. This is what I've seen for Curb Your Enthusiasm. Curb and they share the kitchen, remember?
Mate, very much like that. That's funny you're saying that. And
this is my couple.
Because I was like, I need to bump into him, man. I've got to.
You've been hanging about the kitchen until I go out there, haven't
right?
you?
Well, no, it's funny you say that, right? Because long story short, I went in with another person, and it was me and James, and we spoke for about 5 minutes. And the guy that I was with went, well done, Grado, mate. I mean, he's only one of Hollywood's biggest movie stars.
Aye.
What about asking him about how he's getting on? How he's feeling, what he's working on. That was just 5 minutes of me, 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 me. Grado, 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 Grado. Oh,
no. Mate, that's not like him.
Grado's never asked
him. He says you never took a breath. What are you working on and what are you doing here?
What were you saying?
Toodles down and all that, no happening and stuff like that.
That's your common ground.
Cause you joy.
So I can understand why you would talk about
that.
But I was like, oh no, man, was I that bad? He was gone, mate. It's like, he just going to stop talking about you. And then I said something, I don't want to say, I said something that was just a wee bit embarrassing. Anyway, so.
You ever seen Endeavour?
But you know what? Fucking serious, dude, trust me. But you know that way that every time I went out for a vape, every time I went for a pee, I bumped into him, didn't I? Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. Came out of me. Every time I saw him, I kept bumping into him. And I kept coming back into him going, I keep bumping into him, man.
No, it's when a 180, you don't want to bump into him, but you couldn't wait to see him. And then once you feel like you think you've made an arse yourself, you just kind of get away from him.
It's like, play it cool, when you just go, just didn't stop.
Do you know what's funny? But at the end of the day, he's like, ah, man, the phone is deaf. And I was like, just kept bumping into James McAvoy all day, and it was doing my nothing, man.
I was like, every time
I
kept like,
oh no, that's terrible. Imagine having to bump into James McAvoy.
She was just like, she's like, that's just what you did, Graham. That's just what you did.
I was like, aye.
I
love the way she calls him Graham, man. Honestly, I don't know why, man. Every time we're doing panel and I hear Grado and Steph on the phone, it just reminds me of like Jack and Vera from Coronation Street, man.
It's
the way she talks to him. Well, for fuck's sake, Graham.
You need pot noodles.
Graham, you left these fucking pot noodles out again.
Graham.
It's like Graham. Honestly, Graham.
Up your mammy.
He's talking to his ma. It's so funny, man. And I can't computer my heat gone that show away. It's the way she talks to you.
But it's funny sometimes before coming, I remember me and Crofty went to the gym a couple of times.
Remember that wee face?
I think I went about four times. God, I'm still paying that monthly.
You're the worst for that one.
But Crofty pure. Though a bit, no, it's funny when folk call me Graham because I remember getting into the shivels and Crofty was like trying to ask me for shower gel and he's pure going, Graham! Because he didn't want to say Graham. He's going, Graham! Graham!
I think you've told you that before.
Graham! There's something funny about it.
But oh, I've got my hideous Crofty in the shovel with Stilly's hat on. Shouting Graham!
Mate, you know what I was
flip-flops.
Shampooing his wee tattooed. I could just see him with a red icon hat on, but nothing else. A pair of flip-flops and a red icon hat on.
Like that in the mirror.
Like that, coming in the wee bit.
Graham!
His hat covered in shampoo.
That is funny, man.
He's doing stuff down at Fir Park, aren't he, Crofton?
He's
singing his praises, by the way.
Is that right?
I had a meeting with some of the officials at Mullerwell.
Really?
He's really good, aye.
Really? I'm not surprised.
And by the way, he's good at pronouncing Stamatopoulos. He's good at that. He's got that under his
body. Has he worked on that now?
Aye, man.
Because remember you said he was paranoid about that.
He's got a bit weekend, that boy.
He did, aye. Speaking of the football, man, what was it, man? Was it 2-1?
It was 2-1.
It was 2-1.
Aye.
It's a couple of games at the weekend. Anything happened to you?
Pardon me.
Anything happened to you?
What do you mean?
Like, you get a story to tell? Any shite talk to give us?
I can't mind. I'll tell you if I remember.
Right. There was a couple of good games, but by the way, see that Killian Dundee game? Did you watch that? Or did you see any highlights for that? By the way, a shout out, a very, 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 very big shout out to a top Killy supporter, Fraser, who I met at McDonald's the other day, an absolute cracking guy I just got on with him straight away and we're talking about the pod and all that and we've got similar interests and stuff like that. He was just cracking.
Did you ask him how he was or did you just talk about yourself again?
No, I asked him how he was going.
Can I just put this into the chat? Just into the chat. Just the community officers have been carrying out speed checks in various roads in Motherwell. So when we leave here today, just be careful.
Oh, really?
Okay. Just my beautiful wife just updated me on that.
Is that what they're doing?
They must be.
And you are beautiful.
Yeah, she's beautiful. Hello, beautiful. Do you know what's weird?
He's a big Kelly fan.
Oh, your mate for McDonald's. Mate, have you ever went to McDonald's and no made a pal?
I don't think so.
Remember the video he's like, the guy over at the...
And he made a few muckers on Burger King and all, and he was trying to get a Burger King that didn't he?
Aye, that was the day that
all the
Burger King's cash machines went up.
You know what was weird on Saturday? I was saying to Greg, I was in Motherwell on Saturday night. I was running just up the road here because my mate stays up here. No seen him in a while. Anyway, I was in Motherwell, right, and see my mate. He's got a very, very soft spot for Motherwell, right? Mm. He's a Rangers fan, but he loves Motherwell too. Aye. He takes his wee boy and daughter there. So we sat and we watched the Hibs Motherwell game.
Aye.
It was a good wee game. Good wee game. Sitting in a
Was that on Satanta? Was it in Premier Sports?
Did he go Motherwell scored the winner?
Aye, he's got a Motherwell pass to watch it.
Aye. Or did you just watch it in Salou?
Motherwell's no part of the UK. It's on wee island.
What about Halliday doing the Morelos knee slide when he scored?
I saw that. That was funny.
That was pretty funny. That was a good goal.
But by the way, did you see the Isle of the Killing Dundee game, man? They were up 2-0. They had a player sent off. Dundee had a player sent off in the first half, which was a terrible sending off. It was a second yellow. He did get colour. He did get blood. Aye. Come down his face.
Wait a minute. 86 minutes, 88 and 90 plus 4.
Mate, they were doing two bush.
5 minutes to
wow,
go.
Man.
Mate, they were two bush down and see then he scored three
I
goals.
Look strip. It's a fucking.
It's quite old school.
I like that as well. It's got the stripes done it as well, isn't it?
It reminds
stripes.
Me of like an Everton tap.
Aye, it's the same as Everton's away last year, that's why.
Yeah, Kelly needed that win.
Oh, definitely. That's the first win of the season, mate.
Aberdeen as well.
Mm-hmm.
That was a great game as well. Did you watch that? I watched the extended highlights. I didn't watch the whole game. But mm-hmm.
Is that Shanklin's first goal as well this season?
Oh, he scored it last weekend.
Did he? He scored the last minute winner
in Europe and all, didn't he?
Aye, sure.
Oh, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Sorry, Lance.
The Scottish league, it's happening again. All the teams can beat each other apart from that top three.
Aye. Mm-hmm. I've been watching the highlights every weekend, man. It's actually very entertaining.
I'm telling you, see if you took Celtic and Rangers out of that league, an entertaining league it would be. Because you wouldn't know who to bet at the start of the season.
Here's the thing, man. Who would you bet at the start of the season if Rangers set one?
If it was me for this season,
that's looking at it new.
No,
what's
but
happening.
Remember I called them at the start of the season.
You called them every season, didn't you?
I do.
Greg Clark.
Hey, boy. Listen, come back for me when you catch up with him, you cunt.
No, that was a bit frosty.
How dare you? And why? Keep your secretary and lamish to yourself.
That's not secretary.
And look at you setting yourself up, taking a big drink.
I'm nervous.
Yeah, because.
Just remember, I'm editing this, and anything dodgy you say, I can just keep in, mate. I'll get you cancelled.
Again.
There's only so many times you can cancel a man.
Uncancelable.
Why are they clothing hats?
They launched the other day.
It's nice, mate. Nice
wee
burner.
What make is it?
It's my cousin's new clothing line.
Alright. So, you know, man for the boys, no?
Saucer, they're called. I'll get them sorted.
By the way, that's a tidy bonnet.
It's nice, mate. It feels good on.
Alright. Is that their tap or no? Is that their t-shirt too?
No, this is just one.
What does that say? It's Chip Shop?
Chip Shop, mate.
That's a belter.
Because I could only see shop there, because it's covered. I thought it was a wee Top Shop top.
Did you get it in a church?
No, I got it online. I've got two t-shirts for them. The other one's got a big draw on a crocodile and it says low cost.
But Jinky got it free with a special supper or something.
Oh, wait, no, keep that for the programme.
The program.
Are we still talking? Is this recording?
Aye.
All right.
We're still going.
Toe, you all right, mate?
No, because man. I said...
Fine,
fuck's sake. I've completely lost my train of thought.
You were telling us Aberdeen and all that.
So,
who would you back at the start of the season?
Who would I have backed?
I'd have backed the Jambos.
I would have backed Kelly.
Mm? To win the league?
I would have assumed they would have done it. I just like McInnes, I thought.
Say Celtic and Rangers are in the league, so you would have picked Kelly to win the league.
We should do this.
That's a good question. I don't know, in hindsight, it's a stupid guess now because of the second bottom.
Aye.
Or second bottom, isn't it?
Are they still bottom?
The Hearts are bottom.
I just thought,
Jambos are bottom. Oh, they're ninth now.
Hearts are bottom.
That's what I'm saying, Jambos. But
you'd never have predicted
Kelly
that.
Ninth now.
Nobody would have predicted Hearts.
This is what we should do at the start of next season.
Aye.
We should pick a team that's going to win the league.
It's not exactly groundbreaking. You're basically just guessing who's first.
Aye. But Rangers are in the league, but they're not in the league.
But still third, if you know what I mean.
Aye, but it's no in the APATS world.
Not in the APATS league,
it's
not.
The APATS universe. Aye. Rangers and Celtic are done in England.
They've been demoted to the French third division.
Aye. And they play their football here in France.
What about Cali Faso, man? That's not looking good for them, isn't it, no? Oh, Dunk's not taking his wage.
I know.
Yeah,
I know.
Fair play to him.
Fair play.
Aye. Listen, but he then, could buy that full club if he wanted.
Aye, but still, yeah, man, come on.
By the way,
think he will.
Why don't you, Dunk?
Oh, I thought you were going to say take all the money we get for Patreon and buy an Inverness car.
Aye, that's what they do. Tell everybody how much we make for Patreon, Gredo.
Well, I can tell you, it's not enough to buy Inverness.
It's not enough to buy a pie at Inverness.
Buy a pie at Inverness.
Maybe the diesel. We maybe get the diesel up to fucking...
Look at that. Run Aberdeen around and all, but man, that's incredible.
Mate, that dates back.
I think it's 19 wins for 18 games. 18 wins for 19 games.
Because you're taking into account pre-season and all?
No, they only played one pre-season friendly.
Did they? They've not lost a game under him at all?
No.
What's his name?
Jimmy Thelen.
Jimmy Thelen.
So he don't get a late night show in America?
The lip sync battle and all that.
His assistant is James Morden.
Palaversa.
What was your thoughts on an old Motherwell legend coming back into the Scottish game and Simo Vallecari?
Do you know what annoyed me? We get it. The constant pans for the camera. It kept going to him as if it was David Beckham was in the director's
mate,
box.
It was so annoying, actually, mate, man.
It was like, we get it, man. I mean, fair play, they've got a map, but it was like constant. Did you not notice that? I was moaning about it in the chat.
Greg, it was Dana all the time, man.
Mate, it was as if like Posh and Becks were in the director's box. They kept going to like this.
As if they'd appointed George Graham.
Aye, it was like that. It was as if like the St Johnston like board were... The Mafia or something. But fair play, man.
You should put your specs on as well.
I know, man. Because how did you feel? Because that's what you do.
Do you know who's doing well? Dundee United.
Aye.
They're no bad team, man. Good win for them. It's a mirror. Aye, Motherwell too. It's like...
That's a hard place to go, off street. New St Mirren Park.
Do you know
it's
what?
Always going to be off street, isn't
it? I know we always... Some folk gears pelters for this, but... This Nations League just couldn't come. I just think I'm getting right into the league and it's exciting, the league, don't you? Like, no fun as a Rangers fan.
I was going to say that, man. That's just how bad it is for us, man. That you're enjoying watching the Killian and all that. Aye, I know
mental.
You mean. Aye.
Legit.
You say, it's great because see if you go on to YouTube on a Sunday night after all the games have been played, you can
straight
just,
away, 6
you
minutes.
You can watch the extended highlights. Mm-hmm. It's fucking class, man. And do you know what there is in all? There's a lot of good goals getting scored in Scotland now.
Was Aberdeen's one or not, Pete?
Watching Kelly go last week.
Kick against Ndee, man.
Could you drag
it's a screamer.
Up?
I was talking about that last week.
Can you drag it up?
I hadn't seen it when you were talking about it, though.
I've not seen that over here.
It's a belter. He came off the bench and scored it, too. It's a cracker. And,
Aberdeen scored a couple of good goals.
Was Hearts Aberdeen's one or not a good goal?
Hearts is second. The Aberdeen goal should save Hearts is second. But it's a fucking great finish.
Oh, that's it here, isn't it?
Let us.
It's a picture goal, man. I want him.
He's a good player.
I want him in January, mate. Armstrong's good, a great player, but that look at us, mate. 19-year-old.
Oh, he's put it right back where it came from, man.
Silky.
Is he only 19?
19, I think. Unreal, man.
Do you know what? I hear the name David.
And Lennon Miller.
I immediately think Watson makes you an old guy. And I don't know why. It's a surname, it shouldn't, but...
Sure, Johnny, I'll let you hear that.
There's always Watsons for my area, man, growing up. There's always Watsons. Watsons. Aye, hundreds of Watsons.
So, you've got him, you've got...
Danny Armstrong's decent.
Lennon Miller.
There's a couple of players at Killie Alec, by
Lennon
the way.
Lennon Miller get player of the month.
I know.
Actual player of the month, not young player of the month.
Aye. I know. Well, he's in there every week. I know what you mean, but it's like
there's another midfielder at Killie that's I can't remember his name. I don't know if he scored at the weekend, but there's a couple of decent players at Killie.
What's
his name, man?
Line ups at the top, Greg.
I don't know where it is, line ups down. Oh, it's Greg, mate, what are you doing, man?
Greg, you're losing us here, mate.
So, come on.
Lines.
Kennedy, number 10, aye. Oh. And Marley Watkins is
Kennedy,
decent.
Kennedy, Armstrong.
Armstrong's good.
Watson. Watkins and Donnelly are all good players.
Matty Kennedy's not that young, though.
And Lewis Mayo as well, Rangers, ex-Rangers player. But, mate, it's just, it's mental. They were unlucky last weekend against the United, I've got to say that, losing the, because that was a major kick in the balls.
I don't know about that, it's Miles Lane, see Kelly doing all right.
It's funny one, man. You would think I would do that, but I've just got this 10 in a row.
It's probably the Durant McCoy.
Aye. I know. So, have you gotten into the portal in the life of Toll? What's been happening with you?
I can't remember. tell you, I get tickets. Oh. I get tickets to go and see Toto. Anyway.
Oh, Tidy, that'd be good. Where are they playing?
The Hydro, for some reason. I'm never filling the Hydro, man.
Hold the line, man. You got tickets to go and see them?
I did, mate. Aye, I did. Me and Rosanna are going.
You missed it, man.
No, I didn't. Me and Rosanna are going.
Oh!
Is that a song?
Aye, so it's hold the line.
He went like, he said, where are they playing? I should have said Africa.
Aye!
Aye, that'd been Toto funny.
Do you know that Toto done a lot of the music for Michael Jackson's Thriller album?
What, the dog?
I'm not in Kansas anymore, Gredo.
But see, be honest with you, I have to come clean. I don't know any other song apart from Africa.
No, hold the line, you
yeah,
know.
What is that?
Hold the line. Da-na-na-na. Love isn't always on time.
Oh,
also,
I play it sometimes on the
also, I can see your face still shine through the window on the other side.
You're good, man.
Rosanna.
Rosanna.
Mate, that about Rosanna Arquette.
Can it see how...
Do you have your old idol?
Yeah, can we try something? Can I sing a level higher than you did that? Right. Sing Rosanna, right, and then I'll come in, right?
I can see your face still shining through the window on the other side.
Rosanna, Rosanna. No, but you meant to do it underneath it.
All right. Nah, you went too early then. Right, okay. Work on it, we'll come back next week.
Right.
No. Back in it next week, right? Great geese time to work on it.
Yeah, okay.
I like to see some Patreon content you used to work on that.
Stereophonics are doing a gig at Bella Houston Park.
When?
The tour is called Stadium Anthems.
That's going to be a banger of a concert then.
I remember.
June?
I went to see Noel Gallagher.
Yeah, I think we should go.
Yeah, let's go.
I went to see Noel Gallagher at the Roundhouse years ago. And I think I've told you this. I think he's on our things, didn't I? What'd you call him for Stereophonics? It's a woman.
Kelly Jones.
Aye. And I remember he was stunning with, would you call that famous kind of Manchester guy with the grey hair that's...
Paul Weller.
Mm-hmm. And Colin Murray.
Oh, Colin Murray was
it? I just remember going like chanting him in.
Is he from Manchester? He's like a mod.
No, he's from a town called Malice.
Did he sing that? Is he? No, because I love that song.
It's a great song.
It's good song.
Jam? Aye. Jam?
Aye, so anyway, we circle and hang out for him. I've got a great photo. People are going like that. They can know I'm taking photos of them.
You just know Gredo's trying to get Paul Weller's attention to come out, so just Gredo can just tell Paul everything about his life.
Aye, man.
I met Paul Weller, Noel Gallagher at Tina Park, right?
No, did you actually?
Aye,
I'm
kidding on.
Right, and
I was texting him all night. It would have been good if he met somebody that's under a lot of bother than in America. A singer. Could you imagine if he did have a story like that?
Imagine
a freak off.
Imagine.
Was it a freak off?
Imagine.
Sammy, go and delete that photo of me and P. Diddy.
I put the freak in, freak off.
I might get the podcast shut down.
You were at too many freak offs, Sammy.
Listen, I just can't get a picture of my head. J-Lo all looped up, man, sliding down the stairs.
But mate, it wouldn't be on the realm of possibility that you would have bumped into him back today, mate.
I can't believe that night the dog took me back to a freak off, man.
Yo, man, you here to see the dog? Remember that?
Why don't you tell that to the dog?
Tell it to the dog.
Why don't you tell that to the dog?
Oh, that man.
Oh, JB.
What were we talking
JB
about?
JB would have loved that.
When did you meet Nolan?
Right, so I was at Tina Park, right? And I remember Noel Gallagher was doing a wee set in the tent. Mm-hmm. And so I got to the front. I started to get crushed, genuinely. Right? And anyway, listen, a security guard lifted me over and I sat at the other side of the stage, right? So when the gig finished...
I felt it my chest.
No, when the gig finished, I went to walk out, and as I walked out, because I was behind the fence, I walked out that way, and I turned round, and fucking Noel Gallagher and Paul Weller were standing next to me. Oh, and God. I turned round to Noel, and I went like, are you going to the Celtic game tomorrow? That's the only fucking thing I could
say. It's funny the things you say, like, when you're under pressure, innit?
Aye, my mate met Stillian Petrov outside Chinkamites in the town once, mate.
You going to the Celtic game tomorrow? That's funny, man.
What did he say?
He walked up to Stillian Petrov, and he went, thanks for all the Celtic Kings you've done.
Celtic Kings.
I love that.
Oh, man, you do. You get nervous, man, don't you?
Aye, mate. You talk a lot of shite.
Fletch, doesn't he? Any word on Lonnie. He doesn't get nervous, man. He's scarfed his leather jacket on, man.
Look like a pilot for the 50s.
Hi, Jack, I'm Jack. No, you're Gredo.
Oh, man.
Yeah, well, I've not spoke about.
What?
European football.
Oh, no.
I don't
want
to talk about
it. You need to. Yeah, it's the only...
I'm sure glad that we showed that defence up.
Mate, I know, I've seen people say that.
Fuck me, man. Right. Honestly.
Have we not spoke since then?
No.
No, because we were going like that. We fancied Celtic getting points.
I thought we got a point. I thought you should have got a point. But mate, it was an absolute annihilation.
Ah, Stevie, like I says to you in the group chat, it was like walking in on.
No, it was funny what you said.
I know, but
it was a belter. Mate, see that?
It was like, it was genuinely like witnessing a murder happening, man.
Right, I can. Don't, because I'm going to start laughing. I keep laughing because it was funny, man. We can't even talk about it. It was a belter, but
I know.
But see the thing is, right,
every time they went up the park,
right, that's what I'm going to say. Right, no, Dortmund haven't been exactly setting the header alight. Right, Celtic have been on a very rich.
Where are we going here?
Now, right, I want to just get a point across. Right,
okay.
I can see, I can understand a wee bit where Rodgers is coming for initially, but see after 15 minutes of watching that game, need to change it.
It's the same.
I can understand the setup going, do you know what? We're playing really well now. If I even concede a goal, just get out there, try and play the games you've been playing.
And
right?
It's a one each.
And you never know what's going to happen, right? But see, once you see the way that game's playing out, you sort it out a wee bit, man. You change it.
Stevie, it was.
His arrogance is unreal.
It's the soundbite. Like I was saying about Clement last week. This is the same shit we hear for Rodgers, for fucking Ange Postecoglou. Neil Lennon, whoever's playing, it's a learning experience. We haven't learned a fucking thing, man. We haven't learned a thing.
See, out of the three you mentioned there, Lennon's probably missed. Set up better than you.
Lennon's got the best record
in
Europe. The three
of them. And they won in Lazio and all that,
exactly.
But I'm looking at, was it him at winning Lazio or was it Rodgers?
It was Neil Lennon.
Am I right in saying, was there an interview when he said,
he was there again? He was commentating.
No, I know Lennon is, but I'm saying Rodgers is Rodgers. Did he come out and say, I'm not going to change him?
Nah, he basically said that in his post-match interview, didn't he? He said, no, well, we keep doing what we're doing.
You keep doing what we're doing, but why are you coming out saying that it's a learning experience? If you keep doing what you're doing, it's the first sign of madness.
Insanity.
The pressure he put on the board with that wee press conference, you put in a group chat saying this looks like it's frustrated, right? And he's going on about, you want to make an impression in Europe, you need to get the backing to make an impression in Europe, right? But how can you then go, right, fund this so I can try and make an impression in Europe, and then when you get scudded like that and you just keep calling Europe a learning curve?
No, exactly.
Know what I mean?
Exactly, you're dead right there, but see, what I'm worried about, right, I watched that Atlanta on... It was either the next
they played,
night they fucking hammered somebody anyway. Right,
you just need to go there.
We need to go there this week coming, right? And
next week.
And they're going to get fucking hammered again, and they're going to get hammered again, right? I still think that we'll get through this group because see the home games we've got, they're quite favourable.
Who do you play at home? Leipzig.
Can you bring that up now, Greg? I'm not sure if it's Zagreb or Young Boys.
Greg's fucking fingers are going to be killing him today, man. He's bringing all sorts up today.
So,
Bruges at home.
Right.
Bruges, Leipzig, Young Boys.
Right, so we've got Bruges, Leipzig and Young Boys. Leipzig's a toss-up. I think we'll beat Bruges and I think we'll beat Young Boys, but I also think we've got points against Dynamo Zagreb. Right, so it's favourable going to, right, but...
It's no favourable for us, really, is it?
When you look at the fact that Celtic, all right, they went out, they hammered Bratislava 5-1 at home, but then you go, there's no plan B. This is going back to what my problem was with Rodgers in his first tenure at Parkhead. Now, somebody pointed out, he said four Champions League campaigns with Celtic. And at least one time he's conceded six goals.
PSG, Barcelona.
Atletico Madrid, Barcelona. There was another one as well.
Real Madrid, no?
That wasn't Rodgers.
That was Ange, wasn't it?
It's maybe Celtic in the last 4 years or something like that. They've been beaten by six.
PSG, Barcelona, Atletico Madrid, and Dortmund.
Dortmund. So in the last 4 years, we've conceded at least six goals in one game away from home. Now, if it's a learning curve, you're failing your exams,
mate, the thing is, right, you're looking at that, right, you're going, say you do get scudded against Atalanta, right?
You will get fucked after.
Right, so just let's say you have get beat or you have get scudded. It doesn't matter if you get beat, right? You're going, the home games are favourable, right? They are. But see, if you're going, you've been scudded two games in a row, and you're starting to look at the league, and you're going, right, we need to get a win against Leipzig. Leipzig, mate, Leipzig are name mugs, man. See that boy, that Sashwo or something they've got up front? Mate. And then, where you at? What is that?
Mate.
It's not an easy one.
It's no, but it's like it's not, not if you get scudded and you go right, we just need to go and beat Leipzig.
Aye, as if it's never.
Aye, it's not.
We can't say fuck all anyway.
No, we can't.
Take a few Tonkins.
Oh, mate, are you kidding, man? I'm actually
And that's not even in Europe, mate. That's in the league.
By the way,
Tonkins.
Oh, man, a Tonkin.
Mate.
No, they're right good Tonkin in a while.
Fight things I'm going to do to you. Go up them stairs because you're right fucking Tonkin.
It's like, go up that stairlift, you're getting a Tonkin.
Things I'm going to do to you. Gave her a right good Tonkin last night.
What's other words for that? Getting like a good scudding.
Boshed.
Boshed.
Pumped.
Boshed.
Rattled.
Drilled.
Scudded.
Pumped.
Shagged.
Horse.
Aye. Rattled.
Fucked.
Aye.
Leave yours in the comments. What's your favourite?
Aye.
Scudded.
Hey, what about Rangers in Europa?
Mate, that miss.
Oh, mate, I mean.
But to just put, to say, you probably not saw this.
I watched the whole Rangers game.
No, but.
Mate, just there, like, man, go to saw
it. No, I was talking
Rangers,
about.
He's got Rangers TV.
No, what I wanted to bring up was the post match interview with Chelny on Sunday night was quite interesting.
I felt sorry for him, man.
Aye.
He's a nice guy, isn't he?
He was a lovely man.
He's shite, but.
When he's. Fuck off, man. You can't say that.
That's not for him, you're 5.5.
I just got two goals on Sunday night.
I don't care, man.
Mate, you're just.
I don't care.
You're a terrible man.
He's no good.
See, you're shrinking.
I just know that. I should do that.
No, I'm not. I'm.
Do you like Stevie Folads was good? Now, come on.
Aye.
You scored a goal tonight, mate. Come on. I don't see that.
He scored two.
Come on. I know, but the way Stevie was like going, I don't see that.
I'm not saying he's shy. I take that back. I'm just.
If he walked in that door, you'd fucking be like, all right, fuck off.
All right, fuck off.
All right, Chelny, I'm fuck off.
That would be him.
No, you're not your bub. Mate, I have to say, but that was a game changer. Because them gonna. Are you just know when he. But by the way, we had a couple of good chances before that, Chelny.
We actually started really well.
I thought we started off really well. Mm. We just have got absolute.
You know what they say, but.
From middle to front, there's just
no. How you start a race?
No. The thing is, right? That mob.
There's just no clinical one.
See
bit.
That Fafana.
Fafana, man.
He's
unreal.
And who's the other guy?
Oh, Lacazette.
Jerky. Aye, Lacazette.
What was that? Lacazette's second goal. Turn it up.
Just rattled.
By the way, in fair dues, you know, Ali was copping it a wee bit for going. That would be a thing where if he get chopped off, he is right.
Him there as well, Jerky. Aye, he was dynamite.
Aye.
And it was like,
how did that Leon team struggle so bad last year?
And it's like, what was it?
£150 million worth of subs.
I know.
And it is, you could tell in the build up to the game, in some of Clement's interviews as well, they have spent a lot, they're a good team. You knew they were a good team, right?
100%.
This has got to sound mental, right?
Mm?
They were a good team, right? But see the things we've done in Europe over the last few years. I still think we could have took game a few years ago.
Aye, if it was Van Bronckhorst's team, mate.
Aye, 100%.
If we still had...
Aye, exactly. Aye.
If you had Morelos on form, if you had Arfield, if we had... Kent always played well in Europe.
Defensively, they were pretty poor.
Who?
I thought defensively they weren't
good. Mate, that's
They were shaky. Especially for our goal.
Aye.
And mate, I know we say this every week, man. But as you say, turn it up. See that Dessers constantly getting pushed off the ball and looking and moaning about and putting his horns up in the air. I don't think he's ever conceded that. I don't think he's ever got a penalty. And he just...
Mate, he's murder.
Scunners, mate.
He's
murder.
I'm
by.
Aye, same. Anyway,
I watched that Celtic friendly last night. See what you're saying?
Sligo?
Fucking Palmer tried to dive to get a penalty in a friendly against Sligo Rovers.
He scored a hat trick or
I scored a hat trick.
What was that, Celtic beat him or something?
I don't know why they were playing it. I don't know what the reason for the friendly was, but they were just over there.
Because I seen it on Twitter last night, like, lineups. I thought it was like the women's football or something. I didn't know it was
that. Was that no one at Clyde?
I'm going to send Hangman Greg these these goals, right? Wait till you see this.
I don't want to see them next.
No. It's the goals
any
against.
Any cans are died just, no?
It's the goals against Celtic.
There isn't any cans, Greedo. They're on order. It's just beers in there, mate.
Watch these, Greg. Beer, I'm going to send you these, right? Put them on the screen so Henry can see them, so Greedo and Stephen can see them.
Is this the goals for last night at Palmer?
No, it's the goals that Sligo scored.
Right.
Now, you just
how did you score?
3-2.
Celtic
scored twice in the last minute.
Did
you?
Oh, that's new.
Sligo by Toyota. Exactly. Sponsors right. Channel this. 4.
Watch this one, right?
Oofed.
Scott Bain.
Oh, is that right?
Is that Scott Bain?
Whack out, by the way.
See you next one.
What crowd's
that? That sold out.
Oh, no, at all. Oh, at all. That's not good, is it?
Right. Now, for anybody wondering,
that's why you spoke Schmeichel.
For anybody wondering how he's managed to make that number 3 spot his own.
Who is your number 2?
It's the Dundee United guy.
It's Sinisalo, the boy we signed for Aston Villa.
Oh,
really? Right. What happened to the boy that was the Dundee United keeper?
He's Sigrist. Sigrist's away.
Is he away?
He went to.
He was a good goalie.
I
thought he was alright, you know.
He went to.
He always played well against us.
Genk or something.
No,
that was O that went to Genk. But so I know it's just a friendly, I know it's a completely nothing, but
is it Rapid Bucharest?
How are you supposed to stake your claim for a number one spot when
mate, do you do you not think somebody in that position now, if he's went down to third choice, he's just gone? I'm getting a wage every week.
I'm not getting done for that.
Do you know what I mean? Like
pick it up.
Just going.
No low shots, I'm no diving tonight.
Aye, I'm no diving. It's too wet.
When it gets in and all that, picking the bottom net. Hey, come on, boys.
Pick up.
And then turning around and shooting at the defence. Like, what are you talking about? You get fucking Vaseline in your hands.
But you're a third choice goalie. When do you think you're ever going to get a
game? Never mind. Stevie, see if somebody come over to you and be like, mate, I'm going to give you 10 grand a week to sit in your ass.
Exactly.
It's the best job in the world.
Aye.
Without
it's
doubt.
Like, what's his name? Scott Carson at Man City.
It's the third choice goalie. You need to be the third choice. Because if your second choice is
like Scott Carson.
You've got in the back of your head. Back your butt. If your third choice, you're like,
aye, exactly, man. The boys are putting the group chat, man. Get a night out tonight. Oh, fuck, I'll come, man. It's all right. You don't got a game anymore? Aye, but where are you?
Davey, passes at Bifter. Fuck me, man.
But imagine that, man, right?
Oh, and then you hear like the sub goalies, Angel. Oh, no, man. You'll be fine,
you're
mate.
You're like Leon King.
The sub goalie's injured, man. You're on the bench, man, and then the actual goalie gets injured and you need to go and you're like, I can't do it.
But by the way, that must be a mega mental feeling, being a sub goalie and like just being thrown into it. Like, you're thinking about it.
Aye.
Like, what probably is for their mind? They're probably sitting watching, thinking about what they're going to have for their dinner the night and all that, and then the next minute it's like, oh, up, play. Aye, fucking hell, mate, no.
The worst part it would be, like, see if the goalie gets sent off.
Aye.
And you need to go on, but he's been sent off for giving away a penalty.
Aye.
And the first thing you need to do is
I think there would be a buzz. Because you're like, if I save this man,
aye. It's a free hit.
Aye,
you're just
aye, in. It's fair dues.
Aye.
You know what I mean?
Scott Carson at Man City is living the dream.
Aye,
that guy. He's still at Man City.
He's still at City now.
Who was he?
He's a third choice. He's a third choice keeper.
Was there not?
Keeper.
Who
was he?
Who wants to go keeper? Who's done keeper?
Who is it that went to Rex?
Who's your third choice keeper?
Who's the goalie? Greg, who's the goalie that went to Rex?
Mate, who was the goalie that was at Chelsea for 11 years and I think he played once?
Oh, the big tall one.
They're all tall.
No, but he ended up at Man City as well.
Aye, Scott Carson still at City.
No, who's the one I'm talking about?
Yeah,
you would just call him Keepy.
He's got his he's like a guy that was playing for Hangman last week.
Right, for Dumbarton.
Dumbarton, big Bunkongo.
Hey,
what was he calling it when he went to Rexham? He saved the penalty in the last.
You mean having to play with my United?
He's got the podcast.
Aye! Ben, can't say it, come
ben
on!
Ben Foster.
Ben Foster.
Ben Foster.
That's what I'm thinking.
I used to get him mixed up all the time.
You never played with my United, didn't you?
Aye, Ben Foster. Oh, did play for Man United, boy.
Did he?
I kept Butland off the bench.
Oh.
Butland was only there for about 6 months, wasn't he? Are they sponsored by TikTok?
Aye.
Wrexham.
Aye.
That's funny.
Mate, Ryan Reynolds, man.
Is he on TikTok?
What? Ryan Reynolds owns Wrexham.
No, I know, but what's that going to do with TikTok?
No, but he would get any sponsor, you
want. Aye, I'm Ryan Reynolds. Why he sponsored my football team?
Phone him Mr. TikTok.
Aye. He's quite like see the stuff out the banter his with his missus and all that.
Oh, that's he's funny. Class, he cuts around to 40s and all that.
Mate, I seen him. Do you know where I saw they two? At that baked tatty van.
What?
Spudman.
Mate, something I don't think they look good.
Who, Ryan Reynolds and his missus?
No, the baked tatty.
Wait, lively. So I was like, you're turning yourself down, mate.
Mate, I was like, where are you going with this one?
Wait, you seen his big tatty?
He just saw him standing in the queue for a big tatty, man, going, Reynolds isn't looking good, man.
What's your big tatty?
I don't want to say anything about the Spud man, because he's got a, but I just, it's not my.
I don't like big tatties.
I do like big tatties, but I'm no queuing for yours, man.
I think a big potato is fucking beautiful, man.
Do you know who loves it? Leo. Leo loves a big tatty.
Is he?
Oh. Is this it, Grady?
Mate, you've no idea. He gets queued for miles, man. Really? But it's, you know what? It's like, I'm no slagging the guy, but see just the way he puts the butter with the knife and all that into the tatty. He gives me the heave lot.
Look, the queue.
Hey, watch what he does with the knife, right? Look. Right, and see the curry, it's all like tinned and all that. Like, I don't know, there's just something.
Seriously?
And there's nothing fancy about it.
Mate, there's no, but folk love it, man. And it's all that shredded cheese and it's curry and folk ask for things. I don't know, mate. I just, there's something. That's no me, mate.
Wait a minute. That looks like something you could make in the house.
It is.
It's a baked tatty with cheese, a bit of butter.
Is that all that cheese and beans on a baked... That's
mate,
it?
Mate, he's there's honestly...
There's Ryan Reynolds and Blake Lively.
Type in Ryan Reynolds. Oh, and the chilli and all that, look. I'm not a baked... I do like a baked tatty and tuna. I like cheese and coleslaw, actually. And chilli. I do like baked tatties.
So you just like baked tatties?
I like a baked tatty and tuna. I like it with a wee bit of coleslaw. Don't get me wrong, a bit of cold meat now on it.
It's just named every filling that you put in a tatty now.
Baked tatties do nothing for me, man.
It's a pure diet thing for me. Like,
it's good for
me. But you tell yourself that. I remember you did the, what was it, the Watkins diet or something like that? No, the Atkins diet.
And
it
was always the
but I always remember it was like, if you done the Atkins diet right, it was,
is that the one just with meat?
Aye. No.
Zero carbs.
Aye, zero carbs. But like in the fourth day, you were allowed two baked tatties and as much butter as you wanted, right? That was part of the drill. And I'm not joking, I counted during the seconds till I was allowed this baked tatty by the butter, man, and it was the best baked tatty of all time.
Aye, but see the thing, I see if you're sitting and you're starving.
Because, mate, it was in my head all week, man.
You're starving, right? And somebody puts a packet of fucking Jacob's crackers in front of you.
You go to town.
You're like, that is the best cracker I've ever fucking eaten in my life.
Aye,
it doesn't matter. I would consider a mushroom.
No.
If I was starving,
you would not have liked the roll that I had this morning.
Mate, mushrooms are just...
I know, but if think about it, you're starving at your tits, mate.
I would never mushroom.
You would rather starve to death than eat a mushroom.
Mate, mushrooms...
Oh, are we talking about dying now?
Aye.
After dying, that's a different fucking
moment. That's basically what the fucking Atkins diet was.
Fucking eat your jobbies if I was dying.
There's a Patreon video on that. Two dwarfs, one cup.
Two dwarves, one cup. That's brilliant, man.
Two shots, one pint.
Welcome to this week's episode.
By the way, never do that.
Eat shite.
Eat shite. I'm never going to eat shite.
No, just watch.
You've done it a few times.
Aye, by accident.
Aye, I know.
You're going to have to explain that for somebody that's
watched it before. Man,
I'm not telling
he's told
again,
it before.
You get worms.
I know.
You get worms.
God, worms.
You got shite.
You see, your dad, you've been eating shite.
Have you been eating feces? He's asking if you've been eating shite. The doctor, you've been eating feces? I'm like, what's that? he's asking if you've been eating your own shite. You've been eating shite.
The doctor asked you if you had ate shite.
You've heard this.
Have you been eating feces?
No, I know that. I know how he got worms and all of that, but I've never heard this doctor story before.
Oh, mate, he's told us.
Mate, ice cubes.
Mate, that's biblical, that story. He's told it. It's like,
how embarrassing must that have been? But was that embarrassing?
No,
he was a wee boy.
Nah, I couldn't care less. I just wanted my worms dealt with.
Fair dues.
And you just take the peel and it's away that night. They come at it at night.
Did they come at your arse?
Mm.
That's horrible.
Mm-hmm.
What does it feel like?
Worms in your arse.
Itchy?
Very.
Hold on a minute, what does it feel like, worms in your arse? Oh, I'm sorry if I'm not familiar with that fucking
See, shirt. If you imagine right now that you have worms in your arse, that's what it feels like.
I don't like that.
Aye, mate. Well, that's like it, mate.
Aye, that's plenty. Right, come on, move on.
I started this, didn't I? Saying I would the first time. CBD Oil Scotland.
By the way, CBD Oil Scotland would help you.
Mm-hmm.
CBD Oil Scotland. I mean, I swear to God, I am.
Seems like the same advert every week now because he's just like that.
Mate, I'm no joking, and I'm getting so many messages with regards to stuff with CBD, where the likes of people that are getting in touch with me with their sciatica, mm-hmm. they're getting in touch with me for their mental health, any nerve pains, stuff like that. I cannot do without CBD oil now.
Well, to anybody that gets in touch with you, file them onto the CBD oil socials. They're on Facebook, they're on Twitter, they're on Instagram. And I'll tell you something just now, they're fucking second to none. They're second to none. So CBD Oil Scotland, use the code CBD30 for 30% discount and free postage, I believe.
Aye, well,
that's a great deal.
And listen, yeah, once you try it, you're never going to go back.
What can we
never.
Say? And I was lucky enough to try a few prototype
you were?
Combinations, mm-hmm, yep. which are going to be hitting the... I don't know if he wants me to say, but I know for a fact I can't go without having my herbal infusion CBD, and what it basically is, it's like lavender, ginger, see all just the good shit, and you boil it for 10 minutes, right? And then you put a wee dot of CBD, and I swear to God, see, it sets you off for the day, man. It sets you up, it gets you stress-free. I drive up to my work, I don't take coffee in the morning anymore.
Do you know?
Because that sometimes I do.
Is this a drink, Credo?
It's a CBD herbal infusion. So, mate, you boil all the herbs, sort of deal, right? And then what it is I put it in a strainer, boil it. It takes 10 minutes, man. It's a beautiful... And actually what I do is I put a wee bit of honey and a sweetener and a wee bleep, 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 CBD oil, and that's me sorted. I have one in the morning and one at night, and I get it for cbdoilscotland.com. So try it out. It helps me out. My issue with my thigh is literally clearing up now, to the point where I'm not even needing it, but I take the tea.
There you go.
Just to keep me going, man.
cbdoilscotland.com.
CBD oil, you can trust.
A lot of people ask us where we like to go for a wee scoff, where we like to go to dine. We've got something that's a wee bit different if you fancy a wee change. Oh. Effie's Turkish food. You have never experienced a platter of happiness like Effie's.
A platter of happiness?
Mate. That is, mate. Come
on. Back it up. It was
ribs.
Delicious.
Come on.
Wings. Mm-hmm. Lamb chops. Pork chops.
You've got everything.
Aye. This is my long weekend off, so I'm going to head in now.
Mate, do you know the reason why I think you're saying that? Because when we were there, we were doing a podcast, you couldn't embrace it.
Don't get me wrong, it was still delicious.
But that night we went after the big family bash.
Oh man.
It was all right.
I know, you should have been there.
No, baby. You were invited.
I was invited.
Do you know who?
Decided to fuck off.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you know who I wanted a wee shout out for the day as well, where we're talking about Effie's?
Serkan.
We shout out to Serkan, aye, who was an absolute top guy, looked after us. And by the way, if you want to go to Effie's, whether it's in Uddingston or in Glasgow,
yep.
they've got the belly dancers on a Saturday night.
And the one in Merchant City. And you can go to the one in Uddingston, which used to be the old Redstones. It's now Effie's Uddingston, which has been done up and looks fantastic. And the food is obviously...
It really does. Do you know what it's going to be perfect for? I've missed the boat because I'm coming into the Effie's universe mm-hmm. at the end of the summer. See that outside mm-hmm. but at Redstone.
Well, see, because of the Eurozone.
Incredible.
Aye.
Serkan, when you went there in the summer and the Eurozone was on, he had the big screen out there.
Wow.
And you had the canopy.
Aye, mate. See every bit of food that
canopies
was put on the
under
table.
A canopy.
Look at some of that, man. Look at the tatties. Wow. There's, I mean, honest to God, see if you love your mate. If you're a big, big meat eater, mm-hmm. you love it. And by the way, not even just your meat, mm-hmm. but though, there's even all your kind of salad-y type bits and bobs.
I'll tell you what's outstanding. The bread, the blown bread.
Aye, man.
The blown bread. Is
fresh, strong. Right out the oven. There's mm-hmm. some suck-up.
Look at the deals that are doing as well. Look at that. One course for $12.95, two courses for $16.95, and a three-courser for under £20.
This is your express lunch menu, Monday to Friday, 12 till 3.
They also do gift vouchers as well, if mm-hmm. anybody's looking mm-hmm. for yep. a wee gift.
Oh, I know where they do Baba Ganoush.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had that outside okay. the actual turkey.
Mm-hmm. By the way, a wee shout out. Do you know who we should take out for dinner one day?
What? Spicy Esme salad?
Spicy Esme salad, that's funny. I was going to say a wee shout out the day to Woody, a good friend of the show.
Mate, that's weird.
text me now.
Yeah, there we go. Aye. So
he was going to comedy.
Aye, mm-hmm. Was he really?
Aye,
right.
Was going to come.
So shout out to Woody's undergoing a wee bit of an issue right now himself. So we are we're thinking you Woody, my man.
Woody literally just texted me when we were doing the stairs.
Aye, mm-hmm. Woody's a good friend
Woody's
of the show.
Woody's a good friend of the show. Helped us out with our live show as well.
One of the funniest guys you'll ever meet as well.
He's very, very supportive in everything we do, and yes. He's one of the good guys.
And he bought me a bottle of King Billy. Tonic wine.
Remember that for your birthday?
Aye.
That's right.
King Billy Tonic.
He's a riot. He's a riot. But he's an absolute riot.
Woody, we're all thinking of you, mate. Yep.
100%, bro.
To Woody. And also to Effie's, but because Effie's are a big sponsor of the show, and we definitely need to get down there, and we hope to see you as well. And if you do see us down at Effie's, come and say hello. Come and hang out. Take care of yourselves and each other.
If we get another sponsor.
Shh. Wait a minute. You hear that? Yeah, can you hear that?
I usually hate doing this, but I'm not hating it.
Grads, can you hear that?
Do you hear this bit?
No, I'm just surprised because there was a lot of negative vibes in the chat. And
it's still gone. Can you hear that? Hear that? Shh. It's stopped. Nah. It's back.
100% of your claims. G4 claims.
If you've had an accident that hasn't been your fault, get in touch with Greg and the rest of the troops at G4 Claims. You can reach them on
01698-767-172. That's 01698-767-172.
Nicole and the team and Greg are going to make sure that if you are involved in an accident and it's not your fault, do not contact your insurance provider.
Nah.
You don't want to do it. You leave it in the hands of G4 and all the capable people who can take care and making your misery into something a little bit more manageable. They'll give you a like-for-like vehicle replacement. And what else did they do?
I can't remember.
We don't want your insurance company. We want G4 Claims.
We want G4.
G4 Claims.
Hey, that's annoying for
G4 Claims.
G4 Claims.
It's not a fault, Claims.
Easy. Yeah, that's enough.
That's annoying for folks.
And if you contact me personally, I'll pay you 50 quid commission for any claims you pass.
Do you actually?
About that.
That's annoying. Yes.
And I
can
back that up because Sammy's got that as well. Mm-hmm. So if you
Sammy
get
the ice.
Yeah, if you report I'm not
at fault. We've done it.
I know, but you need to tell them this.
Done. Greg just done it.
Right, okay.
Do next week.
That goes to anybody though. That's not just me. If you refer a claim to G4 Claims, you will be paid £50.
So the listeners can earn 50 pounds?
Yep. The listeners can earn 50 quid.
Aye.
There you go. That's why I was trying to extend that a wee bit.
Look, you did it to yourself.
I know. Check me out. The cock of the walk.
Cock of the walk.
Hey, look at this.
Now you're cocking.
Oh, he's peacocking. Toll. Look at this guy.
Toll loves to tell people when he's right, doesn't he, man? He gets up your semi about it, doesn't he?
G4 Claims. Not the full
claims. Made easy. You're muck.
Get the fixtures up for this weekend, Greco.
Greco.
Oh no, it's international.
Oh mate, that's what I'm saying.
Oh my God.
I said that to Crofty. I goes, Crofty, you're a Motherwell fan. I goes, Motherwell are playing well with them now. I goes, is this not just like came at the worst? Like, he's aye. Like, no. I might watch the Scotland games. Fair dues, man. Mate.
Who's Scotland playing?
It's just the Nations League.
You know what that means, don't you? You know what that means? That Crofty's not going to be at our next live show at the Pavilion, which is on an international week.
Okay, so you'll be at the game.
So what date was it again, Steve?
22nd of March, Toll. Half past seven, Saturday, 22nd of March.
Yes, pavilionfeatre.co.uk.
And the best part is Scotland will likely have been playing on the Friday night.
Yes.
That's a good shout, mate.
So yes.
You can have an odd day on the Saturday, turn up to our live show drunk.
At the Pavilion.
And get turned away.
Aye. But we still keep the money for the tickets.
Yay! It's your own fault for getting pissed.
Pavilionthatre.co.uk. Tickets anyway, still available.
Aye, but anyway, Croatia versus Scotland, 5 o'clock kickoff. What do you think, boys?
Croatia win.
Here's the deal, right?
I don't
even know the call-ups. I mean,
Scotland.
Has the Dundee keeper been called up or something? I can't even. Who's the call-ups?
Scotland have a 5 o'clock kickoff on a Saturday night, 15 minutes after. Or the World League games finish.
Is that right, mate?
There's the squad there.
I think that's a shocker.
Do you think so?
Aye.
I know what you mean. Smack my lips, sorry, listeners.
Smack my lips up. Smack my lips up.
Smack.
So I think one of the latest call-ups was that Andrew Irvine.
That's right. Yes, it was.
Andy Irvine.
Who's he when he's at him?
Was there no one Andy Irvine played for Hearts back you there or something like that.
You're not hitting an Aberdeen player?
You're Aberdeen.
That's Brian Irvin. Brian
Irvin. He's a West Ham player.
West Ham.
Oh, we've got a Premier.
We've got a hammer.
Is he Scottish? Is he Scottish?
His name's Irving. Oh, it's Irving.
He's born in Edinburgh.
Aye. Portobello High School.
Derek Rangers.
Where's he been?
Hearts.
Derek Rangers. He also played at Turkuju München.
That is who? Some career.
Turkuju München.
Mate, I think you've got that right, by the way.
Is that, have I said that right?
I can't see, mate.
Yes.
Austria Frankfurt.
Turkuju München. I don't know.
You have, mate.
By the way, that's some career.
You know what, I've heard of that team. There's a few Scottish players that have played for them because it's a... they're set in Bavaria. Right, but they were founded by Turkish people, and that's why you hang me.
Hang me.
There's a lot of people there.
I still don't get why.
You know what I mean, man?
I don't.
I genuinely don't. They were founded by Turks. Right.
Are they a Turkish team?
They're in Germany. They're set in Germany.
Sorry, that makes sense. And you were. I thought they were still based in Turkey and you were saying they're founded by Turks. I'm like, well, it's no surprising, is it?
No, they're set in Germany.
That's interesting. Keep going, Bristol.
Aye. I don't know anymore.
Right, so they were formed in 2009.
They're a recent team.
It was a merger.
I'm sure they've had a couple of famous players playing for them. Because I've heard of them before and I wouldn't have.
Let's find out.
Go to the squad and see if we recognise MD.
There we go.
No. I don't know any of them.
Wait, they call? How do you spell the name of the club again?
It's Turkuju. So T-U-R-K.
Turkugu, Turk, G-U-C-U, München.
Yeah, there's Chuck coming to see us.
Wait, do we see Scottish players that have played for Turkugu, München FC?
I'm sure there was a couple that have played either in Scotland or...
There is no Scottish information that suggests any Scottish players have played for Turkugu, München.
Aye, that's fake news. I'm sorry, bro, but it's fake
news. Mate, it's how fake animated news. You get about it. Now. You started flapping your horns about that.
I know, but...
They're a team.
They're a team, man. They're a team.
I've heard of that team.
And Scottish players have played.
Man,
and
I can't remember why I came across them.
And hang me.
There's a reason why I know them, and I can't remember it. Fuck it, it doesn't matter. Cut that whole bit.
No, it's funny.
No, you did know something.
You got a wee bit right, pal.
Oh, a point for effort.
Aye. 10 out of 10 for effort. Delicate team. There's the team there. Go back to the start, Greco, of the lineups there.
And he's watching Big Brother then, no?
No, mate, that's three times fast, isn't it? John McCracken, Robbie McCrory.
You're too sure on him, no?
I know, man. Craig Gordon, Grant Hanley, Andy Robertson, Porteous, Jack McKenzie, Nicky Devlin.
Jack McKenzie.
By the way, I was thinking it's that same thing, though.
I don't know who he is.
Aye.
Who does Jack McKenzie play for?
To get you mention.
See, if it is, I'm dancing about.
Aye, yeah, didn't you?
He's biography. Is it a biography?
Caps all levels.
They've brought him right in half the street, haven't they?
I'll find it.
Watch this, he'll play for Leeds.
Let's see.
Place for Aberdeen.
Aberdeen. Oh, my other team.
Wait a minute. Go back up. He lost 2.5 years of youth football to knee pain disease. Wow, man.
Knee pain disease? Mm-hmm.
That's a hang.
That's what it says, man. It's not a
knee, but it just sounds pure made up, doesn't it? Just,
you've got knee pain disease.
I can't come into work now. I know. I've got knee pain disease.
Well, that's like what I was like when I had iritis, remember? And I had to phone the fire brigade. I've got iritis. No, what the fuck's that? I was like, my eyes
pushing.
They're like, irate. That's like that, man. Knee pain disease.
Knee pain disease, man. It's wild.
Tol, I've got a question for you.
You ask me that question.
Do you know the Argentinian team that was founded by a Scottish guy? So recently they played in a cup game and they had a Scottish flag on their top.
Right.
Do you know who they are?
I know that there's a lot of Scots have went over to Argentina years and years and years ago because there's quite a lot of Scottish Argentinian names.
Aye, and you see
Alexis
them in
McAllister.
Aye. There's one called Kevin McAllister. He's Alexis McAllister's brother. No, there is actually one called
Kevin. I'm joking. See, it's Home Alone. Calm down, man.
Sorry. I get defensive.
Kevin McAllister, right. Home Alone.
Wait a minute. So, is it? It's no Newell's, isn't it? No? Greg.
What's that?
Is it Newell's Old Boys?
No. It's a team called Rosario
Central.
Oh, Rosario Central.
Founded by Colin Bain Calder, a man from Dingwall in Scotland.
There you go. I didn't know Rosario was founded by a Scotsman, did you?
No.
There you go. What's that?
That's the...
Is that their jersey?
Wow.
That's their third kit.
Could you imagine Scotland releasing a tap like that?
Scotland, we'd had an away like that. Remember, it was white with a blue.
Sure, they did. Aye, the kind of light blue.
Aye, that was
a cracking tap.
That for its day. Scored against France.
McFadden.
Aye.
It reminds me of Alan Hutton, that tap.
Aye.
Who
do you remember? Gary Caldwell was running about that.
It's funny, I like when we play games like that, when you go name who reminds you of the tap.
Aye, that's good.
That's good, isn't it?
Let's do that for the Patreon.
Mm-hmm. Billy, aye. Ryan Gold, Scott McTominay, Kenny McLean.
So Billy Gilmour, Ryan Gold, Scott McTominay, Kenny McLean, Ryan Christie.
Right, Forrest, Lewis Morgan, Ben Doak.
One midfielder that plays in Scotland.
Mate, it's funny because we're talking about it in commentary the other night about how, like, Rangers have got suitor.
I agree with you, but see, but for me, right, man. Andrew Irvine, who's playing for West Ham, right?
Aye.
Kenny McLean. Why are we not bringing in players like Lennon Miller and these boys for Kilmarnock?
I know, mate.
Aye, Watson, mate, is a defo shout, but look at that midfield, but it's quite busy, yeah. It's quite busy when it comes to midfielders and stuff. And you could say,
I understand that they wouldn't play great, though, but that gets them that experience of being in and about that squad.
Oh, I'm not saying that I don't agree.
Like you said earlier, Lennon Miller just get played a month.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And they're playing, you know, that's invaluable, that sort of experience.
Steve Clark.
Mate, I totally hear what you're saying. I think they get called up for the B team, but did they know?
He's in the under 18s and the under 21s, I'm sure, but.
I think Max Johnson and Lennon Miller should be in the
fight. Max Johnson's absolutely tearing it up. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Who is it? He plays for Austria.
Sturm Graz.
And he's doing well. There's English teams all looking at him and all of that.
Aye.
So, like Ben Doak, fair dues. He's at Liverpool, but what game time is he getting?
I know.
And he's benefiting for training with all the players every day.
When you've got Lennon Miller, who's just got played in a month for his club.
And no disrespect to Motherwell, but going up to international level, it's another string to your bow. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
So he's also played more than 50 games for Motherwell. Do you know what I mean? He's experienced for a young guy.
Aye.
Exactly, and he's not letting up. He's just getting better.
He's a tidy player, man.
Did his father ever get called up for Scotland?
He was in the Kieran Cup team that.
I'm sure he won it.
Could be a tourism check.
What was that? The Wick Cup.
The Kieran Cup.
Remember they went away and they won it.
I don't remember that.
Aye.
Who was that?
Where was you?
Don't know, mate. It was in about 2002 or something like that.
I don't remember that. Was that Betty Vogt, Sarah?
No.
Who would that have been then? Would you be crying Burley? George Burley?
No, Waller Smith was the manager at the time.
Oh, Davy Weir. Oh, God, I have no memory of that, boys.
Yeah, Darren Fletcher.
I have no memories of that.
That's Gary Teal.
Looks like Darren Fletcher there, didn't he? Gary Teal played for them.
Theodora.
There's a squad there.
Wow, Neil Alexander, man. Went to a European final. Graham Smith. Graham Smith. By the way, he would have been on the bench for Rangers. Manchester.
Remember Nigel Quasi?
Smitty.
Nigel Quasi.
Aye, Nigel Quasi. He was good for Scotland.
Aye, was.
By the way, somebody DM'd me on Instagram last night going, how can I get a Grado leotard? Should I just say,
Jamie Lanfield. Right, boys, I'm going out to Bush soon, man.
Graham Murty was in the team, or no?
Was he? Shut up.
Big Dirty Murty.
Jesus, man.
No.
Oh, my God.
Mate, I'm going
to let me close there.
Mate.
Jesus, man.
I didn't
That's
even
unbelievable.
Know Graham Murty played for Scotland.
Aye, I knew that.
Neither I did. Before his handstand career.
Mate, that's iconic, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
Jackie's got a photo of that hanging up in his hall. Jesus.
Who knows, man? Who knows? Right, are we going to this meeting?
He doesn't look right, you know?
He
fit with him.
No, he doesn't. Do you know what he looks like? Just like your PE teacher or something.
Look at that, Scotland tap. That was honking. Remember that burgundy fucking thing?
Keep that for Patreon.
Is Graham Murty still at Rangers?
No.
Right, let's toast Bob goodbye.
Right, Bob.
Right, Bob, thanks very much for taking part in the pod. Good luck in your future endeavours. Hope everything's well done. Tell them all we're asking for them. Didn't show that. Anyway, if you want to catch me and Toll have a wee blether, extra blether, then you can catch us on the Patreon. It's Patreon APATS. Everybody,
catch
you after, man.